Now, up to this point in time, you've been dealing largely with retailers. Now, a retailer will buy their trading stock and then they will sell it. In this section, we're looking at our cost accounting or the manufacturing. And in this case, we are actually going to be making the goods. Now, the cost of that manufacturing needs to be determined. If you were buying t-shirts from somebody else, you would know exactly what the cost was. But if you are making them, it's not as clear. And so you're going to have to bring into account the various costs that go into making that item. Now, largely, we've got three different cost components, and this will either be assessed in the form of ledger accounts, separate ledger accounts, or when you get to grade 12, it'll be in the form of notes. And the first thing we're going to have to do is look at our raw materials. Now, it's not only obviously rolls of material, it could be cottons, it could be zips, it could be labels, and so on. All the raw materials, but raw materials actually go into the goods. So you can physically see a label, cotton, and so on. Now, that material then has to then be converted. So you will have what we call the direct labor cost. These are the people that would be cutting this out, that would be sewing it, would be packing it. Their job is directly involved with making of the t-shirts. And then thirdly, the last of your cost is your factory overheads. These are your other costs that are involved. These costs are not directly found in your item, but there'll be things like your electricity, your rent, your depreciation, your consumable stores, all things that are needed to run the factory. Very similar to a retailer who also has all the expenses to run. Now, we will work out the cost of each one of these separately because we need to control it. We need to know what raw materials are costing and if there's an increase, why. So these three have to be worked out separately. Then, once you've got those costs, they are brought together in a work in process stock account. Now, I know it sounds strange having stock, but that's what we're doing. We're producing stock, but it's the work in process. So these items come into the factory. Imagine this is the actual bringing it all together. And from there, the completed items will be going out. Now, those completed items are finished. So now they go out of the factory and they go into your finished goods. This finished goods now at this point is almost the same as your trading stock account. The only difference is you've got items here that you made, whereas in a trading stock account, you've got items that you actually bought from somebody else. So you might have an opening stock of goods, and the goods will be flowing from the factory into the finished goods, into the storeroom, into the shop, into the sales areas. And then, obviously, why did we make this? From there, we will then be selling the goods, and we at that point make our profit, we'll have our sales, and we'll have our cost of sales. Now, it is important that you see this flow that is going through. So you start with your costs, work out the cost of each one. Go to the work in process, that goes into the finished goods, and finally it'll go out as your stock. So now let's look at that in the actual ledger accounts. Remember, your work in process is bringing the three cost components together: the direct materials, the direct labor, and the factory overhead. So those are your costs that you've been incurred. Now, in many factories, the items could be partially completed at the end of a day, at the end of your financial year. So it is possible to have an opening balance. These are the partially completed goods: half-made t-shirts, quarter-made t-shirts, and so on. You then added on all of your costs for this year. As these goods are completed, they leave the factory. So you're minusing away from the work in process, and that goes into the finished goods. And that's an important link that you see that. So out of factory into finished goods. Again, it is possible that you don't have all your goods completed. They might be partially completed items, and so there will be a balance which will be carried into next year. Now, generally, you are given these balances or they just become a missing figure. You're not going to be expected to go and value goods a half and a quarter and so on. If we then look at our finished goods stock, as I said to you, exactly the same as the trading stock, except we're just calling it a different name. So you might have a stock of goods already at the beginning. And coming out of the factory, you are adding on as these goods have been made. These goods are made to be sold, so as they go out, exactly the same as our trading stock, to a cost of sales. And again, we might have a balance of trading stock, finished good, that is left over at the end of that particular period. And you'll start the next year off with an opening balance of 33,000. Now, these questions in your study guide don't ask you for all of the ledger accounts, and it's something that you need to realize, that you have to be able to draw up the separate accounts individually. So here, let's just look at the factory overhead costs. These are your overheads, your expenses for this year. So there could be consumer stores, insurance, all of these are all expenses, but very importantly, they're only factory expenses. Besides the factory, there'll be other cost components. There'll be administration, the office, and the selling and distribution. You are focusing here on the factory, so it's only the factory share of these expenses. So some of them, for example, have to be divided in relation to the floor space, or by three quarters, or the insurance of 70% is being used by the factory. You'll be given those figures. But important to remember, these are all factory expenses. The cost account has brought them all together, so you can get your total factory overhead, and that is what have gone into the work in process. And so we're back looking at this work in process stock account. And then the other ledger account that you often get asked is to do the direct or the raw material stock. Now, again, it's nothing dissimilar from your trading stock account. You're just looking at rolls of material or whatever the raw materials actually are. So you could have a balance of the raw materials. In the storeroom is a whole lot of material. You're going to buy that because you've got to get that material into the shop. So you buy it either for cash or on credit. Out of the storeroom, that gets issued then to the factory. So it goes out of here into the raw materials, issued account, and then finally into the work in process account. And it's possible that you could have some stock left over. Now, it's important that you see the flow and the link that is coming between them, because often you have to calculate a figure and you have to complete another ledger account to find a missing figure here. For example, I might not give you the raw materials issued and I might not give you the balance. So there's no ways you can find this figure. But you might have had to do a work in process and you might be able to find the raw materials issued there. So you need to understand the flow of all of this.